What's going on, guys and gals, and welcome to Good Real Hunting. Where it is currently Good Real Hunting, Burt Man. What does that mean we're looking for?
That means we're hunting for the spooky reels, so you do not have to. And man, we are going out of territory today in this one.
Yes, we are, man. Got the Brett man over there. Brad's over here. Today, we're talking about a fan film we've been anticipating for years now, it seems like, and that's My Special Boy, directed by our boys, Braden Timmons and James Grimm, man, co-directors. And, you know, obviously, it's a Friday the 13th fan film. Jason's played by our other boy, Chad Sumner. A lot of fun. This thing, you know, you guys have heard about it if you've been following the channel for any time whatsoever. We've been talking about it for a long time, highly anticipating it. And the day's finally come, man. It is here. It is here for the people, man.
It is finally here, and I finally got to saw who gets to win the epic fight, but we are going to make this spoiler-free, so we're not going to tell you who wins. So right after you listen to our review, you better head on over to James Grimm's YouTube channel where you can watch it yourself for My Special Boy, a Friday the 13th fan film. And so, Brad, what did you friggin' like about this thing?
Well, there's a lot of things I like, but the biggest thing for me is the connection they had with, or I guess the story that they told with Pam and Jason Voorhees, their connection. Mm-hmm. You know, all that stuff out here, and this it's done really well. Honestly, it's done better here than it is in the first couple movies in the franchise, because they really just don't really have that connection. And because, you know, it started off with the original Friday the 13th, and then Jason just kind of pops up out of nowhere. This has the advantage of actually telling us that story of what drives Jason and whatnot, and how his, you know, the death of his mom impacted him and all that cool stuff. It's really neat. I like the way they did it. And I think it's a really cool way to take the story. And it goes really back to the roots of the franchise, I think, going back to a nice camp setting, which is really cool.
Thank you, Little Roots. But no, dude, I absolutely agree with you. The connection between Pamela Voorhees and Jason Voorhees was really spot on. I kind of like how like Mrs. Voorhees was like a ghost, like, and we get to see that kind of interaction. We get to see what Jason is seeing. I thought that was a really nice touch and a very good decision to make if you're going to bring on Pamela Voorhees' character. And of course, I believe the actress's name is Gia is her name. And I thought she was one of the standouts in acting with being Pamela Voorhees.
Gia Rose,
Gia. So she knocked it out of the park.
Yeah, I really another thing too, for a fan film, I thought the acting was actually done really well, and the dialogue was actually really good for, you know, one of the better written fan films I've seen when it comes to dialogue and stuff. And I thought the actors, they all did a really good job of bringing the characters to life. A big standout for me is April, the person that played April, and that's Abby Gia.
Yeah, Abigail. Thought,
yeah, she was she did a really good job. And but everybody else did too. It was a strong cast.
Oh yeah, strong cast. And then of course Brandon Tibbetts, baby, was really good with his character as well. I thought he was really strong with his character, brought it to life, and everybody else did a really good job too. But the man of the hour is one Mr. Jason Voorhees, played by Chad Sumner. He did an amazing job, not just being Jason Voorhees, but bring his own style to the Jason Voorhees mm-hmm. character. And I was really impressed for what he did with it, just to make it his own. Because do you know how tough it is to make an iconic character like that, just to make it your own like thing? Chad did it with ease, and I was really impressed. So Chad, great job, buddy. I know give you a lot of shit on some things, but I can never give you shit on that, because that was freaking terrific.
Chad was badass, man, and he took a lot of traits from some of the other Jason actors, and he put it into this performance. But like you said, he does his own thing with it, and it's really impressive. And I think they did an interesting thing here in this movie by giving Jason a new look, and unique look for the look, you know, for Jason, with a different mask, different attire. And I think it works. It pays off really well. I think I really dig what they did with it. And you talked about Braden Timmons a minute ago, baby. He has one of the best one-liners in this thing you'll ever see in a damn Friday the 13th movie. I won't spoil it.
I think
it to
I know
you,
which one you're talking about. Yeah, sir. So, and another thing too is I really enjoyed the kills. I understand it's a fan film, so they can't go fully all the way with what they wanted, but it's just to see what they wanted to do and how they play off a lot of those kills. Really damn impressive and really creative. And of course, there's like one in particular where a practical effect looked terrific.
Yeah, dude, the effects in general are really good. I don't know what the budget was for this. Do you have any idea?
I
You know how
don't know
much
on
they
the top of
raised?
my head.
Okay. I don't feel like it was like a bonkers amount of money that they raised for this. And for what they did have though, I think they did a really good job. I thought a couple one of the kills in specifically looked really good for, for what they had to work with, and it was solid. And yeah, I thought the rest of the kills were all creative. And yeah, a lot of that, like you said, comes back to Jason too, just being freaking badass from Chad.
Oh yeah, absolutely badass, man. And do you have any other positives about this fan flick?
I do. There's one badass, really good cameo in here. I think you guys are all gonna really enjoy that. It popped up, and I don't know if it's supposed to be a surprise or not. I know it's on the cast list, but I'm not gonna say it here. But you guys will all know it when you see it. And man, I had that freaking that Leo moment pointing at the TV when it popped up though. Yeah, it was really good
Oh
for people.
yeah, man. Event.
Anybody in the YouTube community is gonna freaking lose their shit, I think.
Oh, dude, absolutely they are. And I'm like, I was like, even after I got done, you texted me saying, "Dude, did you catch so and so?" I went, "What?" And so I rewinded real quick and I found them. I'm like, yep, there he is. So yeah, get ready for that cameo. It's a little cameo, but it's still fun when you always see someone that you know in the community doing something really special. And then the last positive I have too, I thought the score was really good too. So props
Oh, yeah.
to everybody that was responsible for the score with composing the music, creating the music, placing the music within this entire film. Really great job, guys.
Yeah, for sure, man. I really like the way the score added to the movie. I like that quite a bit. I like the pacing a lot too. A lot of fan films out there are, this one's 1 hour and 10 minutes or so, but it goes by fast. It's easy to, get caught into a fan film that feels like it's kind of dragging. This one never, ne this one doesn't feel that way. The pace moves at a, pretty quickly. There's a lot of, there's a lot of good stuff going on throughout the beginning. There's a lot of intrigue in the story. I like the way they wrote everything in, and the Camp Trinity Point aspect. I like all that. It's really well done, I think. And yeah, there's enough to keep you intrigued the whole runtime.
Oh, dude, absolutely, dude. Yeah, the pacing—that's a really good word for it. Because, like, I appreciate them just making it an hour. Like, they could have made it longer if, again, had budget and all that. But we've been noticing lately that you don't need to go that long if you just tell your story and just go with it. Even if it's like 50 minutes to an hour, like that's still a good length time for a fan film. Be able to tell the story that you all want to tell. So yeah, excellent job. My special boy really knocked it out of the park with the pacing and just following along with the story of this film.
But in short, man, I think anybody fans of the Friday 13th franchise are going to love this. If you haven't seen it yet, check it out. Do we know it's not on, do you know what YouTube channel it's on? We should probably get that on there
It's
and
on
put it on.
James Grimm's YouTube channel, and that link to that particular fan film will
Perfect.
be in the description down below. So I'm not going to go into too detail with him right now with the spoiler free. I'll save my thoughts for when we bring on the cast of My Special Boy for our next Good Real Life.
Yeah, hell yeah, man. That'll be a fun discussion. We'll go deeper into it and everything like that. And yeah, it's going to be a really good time.
Oh, dude, such a good time. And that Good Real Life with the My Special Boy cast and crew is going to be on November the 3rd. And so be sure to hit that notification bell once we get that stream up and loaded so you all won't miss such a good interview. But yeah, Brad, overall thoughts real quick. We decide we are not going to do ratings for fan films anymore, but we are always going to give that thumbs up for a seal of approval.
Yeah, dude, definitely approve it. Check it out. If you're like I said, this is a really good movie to introduce yourself to fan films. If you haven't seen one yet before, if you haven't seen Never Hike Alone or Haddonfield Nightmare or It's Me, Billy, this is a good one to introduce yourself to. I think it really is. And yeah, it's right up there with the best of them, in my opinion. It's a really well done production. So check it out.
Oh, yeah, dude. I will double down on that for you too, saying that this particular Friday the 13th fan film is definitely one of the top ones in all of YouTube entertainment. So if you love Jason being brutal, if you want to see Jason's mama, and if you want to see some people die, watch this right now, or watch the fan film right now, and then you are going to be one happy Friday the 13th fan.
Yes.
Hell yeah. So I'm going to go ahead and ask you guys, what did you all think about My Special Boy, a Friday the 13th fan film? Do you think this is one of the absolute best Friday the 13th fan films out there in the world of YouTube and fan films? Or do you have some problems with it? Let us know in that comment section down below, and let's get that discussion rolling.
And if you want to help us find the good reels, you can do so by finding us on Facebook, Instagram, Letterboxd, Twitter, TikTok, and of course, Patreon. Those are links are for you to find right down below.
Abso-frickin-lutely. And be sure to like this video, share, and subscribe, because we are on that quest to the 1K, and we would appreciate all your support. And of course, ring that bell, ding, 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 so you all know what the next set of movie reviews is up and ready, because, oh boy almighty, what we got coming up on movie reviews, you don't want to miss it.
No, dude, it's going to be epic, dude. A lot of fun.
Oh, yeah. So we're out of here, and we'll see you guys later, and be sure to wear, like, your freaking floaties and your flippy floppies at camp.
Yes. Don't drown.
No, yeah, definitely don't drown. We're not